Now we will solve some questions based on the concept of area. Here I wrote based on the concept of area. I haven't written the questions related to area, because some questions, while reading the question, we cannot think that it is related to area, but the main concept will come of area only. So we'll start with first question. In first question it is written, in a rectangle the length is increased and breadth is reduced or decreased by 2 units. So here again length and breadth is asked, and the question given is find the area and perimeter of the rectangle. So again, to find out the area and perimeter, we need the length and breadth. So we can take, let the length be x and breadth be y. So at present I have taken the length of the rectangle as x and breadth of the rectangle as y. So can you tell me what will be the area of the rectangle? What is the formula for area of rectangle? Length into breadth. So that will be equal to x into y. So instead of writing x into y, directly we can write xy. So our area will be equal to xy. Now we can check what is the condition given in the question. Now they says, if length is increased by 2 units. So length is increased by 2 units means our length will be equal to x plus 2, and breadth is reduced by 2 units. Breadth is reduced means breadth is decreased by 2 units. So our breadth will be equal to y minus 2. So if length is x plus 2 and breadth is y minus 2, then according to the concept of area, our area should be equal to L into B. So x plus 2 into y minus 2. Now what the condition is given, when we are doing in this way, the area is reduced by 28 units square, or 28 square unit. So when we are doing some modifications in length and breadth, our original area is reduced by 28 units square. Our original area was equal to xy. It is decreased by 28 units square. So it will be equal to xy minus 28. This is the area which we will get, but this area is smaller than the original area by 28. Clear? Okay. Now we will simplify this. So it will be equal to xy minus 2x. X will be multiplied by both the terms. Then 2 will be multiplied by both the terms. Plus 2y minus 4 is equal to xy minus 28. As you can check there, xy sign is same. So if I will shift in this side, it will become minus xy. So both will get cancelled. So at present I am not writing that cancellation. Directly I am writing the next step. So next step, it will be equal to minus 2x plus 2y minus 4 is equal to minus 28. So next step, minus 4 we can shift to right hand side. Then it will be equal to minus 2x plus 2y is equal to minus 28 plus 4. So that will be equal to minus 24. As you can check, all the terms are divisible by 2. So we can cancel it by 2. So our equation will be equal to minus x plus y is equal to minus 12. And normally we are writing the coefficient of x positive. So to make it positive, what we will do? Yes, we will multiply it by negative sign. So our first equation will be equal to x minus y is equal to 12. Now we can check what will be our second equation. To frame the second equation, condition given, if the length is reduced by 1 unit. Length is reduced by 1 unit and breadth is increased by 2 units. This way if we are doing, then our original area increases by 33 square units. So our original area was xy. How much difference is there? This increases by 33 units. So equation will come in this way. X minus 1 into y plus 2 is equal to xy plus 33. Again, we will simplify it. Then it will be equal to xy plus 2x minus y minus 2 is equal to xy plus 33. Again, xy and xy will get cancelled. Remaining it will be equal to 2x minus y minus 2 is equal to 33. Minus 2 we can shift to right hand side. Then we will get 2x minus y is equal to 33 plus 2, 35. This is our equation 2. Now we can solve equation 1 and 2. As you can check, coefficient of y is same only. So we can simplify by elimination method. Two equations written. So I am writing the equation once again here. Second equation, that is 2x minus y is equal to 35. Now what we will do? Addition or subtraction? Yes, we will do subtraction. So if we will subtract, what will come? Here it will become negative, positive, negative. So minus y and plus y cancelled. 2x minus x, x. 35 minus 12. So 5 minus 2, 3. 3 minus 1, 2. So we got x is equal to 23. Now we can substitute the value of x in any one of the equation. We have x minus y is equal to 12. We can substitute here only. 23 minus y, x minus y is equal to 12. 23 minus y is equal to 12. So y will be equal to 23 minus 12. 3 minus 2, 1. 2 minus 1, 1. So we are getting x is equal to 23 and y is equal to 11. But question asked, find the area and perimeter of the rectangle. Now we can calculate the area. Area is equal to, formula is length into breadth. So we can multiply these two. Our length is 23 and breadth is 11. So 11 into 23. 11 threes are 33. Carry over 3. 11 twos are 22 plus 3 will be equal to 25. So 253. Nothing is given. That's why we are writing unit square or square units. Both are same. And then we have to calculate the perimeter. Formula for perimeter of a rectangle is 2 into L plus B. 2 into our L. Length we have taken as X. So 2 into 23 plus 11. 23 plus 11 will be equal to 3 plus 1, 4. 2 plus 1, 3. So 2 into 34. 2 into 34 will be equal to 2 fours are 8. 2 threes are 6. Here unit of perimeter is units only. A unit of area only, unit square. And perimeter is unit. So I think the method is clear to you. Moving on to the next question. Next question also related to area. Question is given, the area of a rectangle remains the same if the length is increased by 7 meter and breadth is decreased by 3 meter. The area remains unaffected if the length is decreased by 7 meter and breadth is increased by 5 meter. Find the dimensions of the rectangle. Dimensions of the rectangle means we have to find the length and breadth of the rectangle. So already I wrote there, let the length be x and breadth be y. Now, in this case, what will be the area? Area is equal to xy. Now, we can check what is the condition given. If the length is increased by 7 meter. Length is increased by 7 means that will be equal to x plus 7. And breadth is decreased by 3 meter. Breadth is decreased by 3 meter. So, in this case, area will be equal to, this is the length into breadth. But what they gave? The area remains the same. There is no change in area if we are increasing, we are changing the length and breadth. Area remains the same, it is given. Now we can simplify it, then it will come xy minus 3x plus 7y minus 21 is equal to xy. So again xy and xy will get cancelled. So remaining it will be equal to minus 3x plus 7y minus 21 is equal to 0. Or we can multiply it by negative sign, then it will be equal to 3x minus 7y plus 21 is equal to 0. Equation 1. Now to frame the second equation, we can check what is the condition given. It is written the area remains unaffected, means there is no change in the area if the length is decreased by 7 meter. Now length is decreased by 7, so x minus 7, and breadth is increased by 5 meter, so y plus 5. Then also there is no change in the area, it will be equal to the original area, and original area is xy. Now we can simplify it, then it will be equal to xy plus 5x minus 7y minus 35 is equal to xy. So again xy and xy will get cancelled, so our equation will be equal to 5x minus 7y minus 35 is equal to 0, second equation. So now I think you can solve these two equations to find out the values of x and y. So I am writing the answer here. Your length we have taken as x, so your length will be equal to 28 meter and breadth will be equal to 15 meter. Just to check whether you are getting this answer or not, just to make a change in this question, I have taken the length as L and breadth as B only there, because you will be habitual in solving the question related to x and y, because then if any other variable will come, sometimes you will get confused there. So that's why I have taken the length as L and breadth as B only. Now we can check the question what is given. Half the perimeter of a garden whose length is 3 less than twice its width is 48 meter. Half the perimeter of garden is given and condition is given, length and breadth is given. Then which one it will be? Yes, it will be a rectangle only. So first we can check what is the condition given. Length equal to 3 less than. 3 less than means that it will be equal to minus 3. Always whenever subtraction is there, right afterwards there. 3 less than twice its width. Twice its width we have taken as B. So length is equal to 3 less than twice its width. This condition is given. L is equal to 2B minus 3. So make it equation number 1. Or if you are using elimination method, you can shift all the expression to one side. Now we can check what is the information given. Half the perimeter of a garden. Half the perimeter of a garden. What is the formula for perimeter of a garden? Yes, 2 into length plus breadth. Length and breadth is given. That's why we have taken it as a rectangular garden. Is half the perimeter of a garden is 48 meter. Is 48 meter is given. So again here 2 and 2 will get cancelled. We will get L plus B is equal to 48. This is the second equation. So you can solve these two equations, and when you will solve, you will get length is equal to 31 meter and breadth is equal to 17 meter. Now question number 4 is not directly is given in terms of area there. Just to check how we are going to use the concept of area in this question. Students of a class are made to stand in rows there. So I am writing in this way. Some students we are arranging them in rows. In this way we are arranging the student in rows, and if one student is extra in a row, after that condition is given, find the so this is the row. Suppose I have 4 rows there and 5 students are sitting in a row. 5 students are there in a row. So how many students are there in the class? Can you tell me? There are 4 rows and number of student in each row I have taken as 5 there. So can you tell me how many students are there? In this row how many? 5. In this also 5. So it will be equal to 5 into 4. What is this one which we have taken there? This one is length, and if we will consider this one as breadth. So 5 into 4. Number of rows is 4 and number of student in each row we have taken as 5. So total number of students will be equal to 5 into 4. So again, what we are going to use, we are going to use the concept of area only. So here two things are there. First is number of rows and then number of student in each row. So here we will take, let the number of rows be, let the number of rows be x and number of student, number of students in each row, number of students in each row be y. Then total how many students will be there? Total students is equal to, what will come? Total student is equal to, yes, it will be equal to x into y. As I explained you here, if the number of rows is 3 and number of student in each row, as social distancing is there, so suppose if only 2 students are sitting in a row, the number of student in each row is equal to 2. So here total how many students are there? 3 plus 3, 6. Or what we can do? 3 into 2, 6. So again, this is related to area. Now we can check what is the information given. If one student is extra in a row, we have taken number of student in each row as y. So if one student is extra in a row, so that will be equal to y plus 1. There would be 2 rows less. Number of rows we have taken as x. So there would be 2 rows less, x minus 2. So number of student will be equal to x minus 2 into y plus 1. But whatever you will do, number of students will remain the same only. It will not change. So this is equal to xy. So again, we will simplify it. Then it will be equal to xy plus x minus 2y minus 2 is equal to xy. So xy and xy will get cancelled. Our first equation will be x minus 2y is equal to 2. Make it equation number 1. In the same way, next, what is the condition written? Number of student, if one student is less in a row. So in a row, number of student we have taken as y. So if one student is less in a row, there would be 3 rows more. There would be 3 rows more. Again, this will be equal to number of student. That is equal to xy. There won't be any changes. Again, simplify it. Then we will get xy minus x plus 3y minus 3 is equal to xy. Again, xy and xy will get cancelled. And then you will get minus x plus 3y is equal to 3. Or if you want, you can multiply it by negative sign. Then we will get x minus 3y is equal to minus 3. Equation 2. So you can solve the 2 equation and find out the values of x and y. But that is not the answer. We have to find out the total number of students. So total number of students we have taken as x into y. So just to check whether you are getting the answer 60 or not. Next question is related to speed. A train covered a certain distance at a uniform speed. If the train, now speed, uniform speed covers a certain distance. Distance they haven't given there. So distance we have to take as a constant only. We know speed is equal to distance by time. So from here, if I will shift t to left hand side, then it will get multiplied by speed. So speed into time, they covered a certain distance at a uniform speed. So if you will relate it to area, area is equal to length into breadth. So that's why I have included this question in this concept only. Now we can check what is the information given. A train covered a certain distance at a uniform speed. If the train would have been 6 km per hour faster, then it would have taken time less. So two things are given. The speed they are changing and they are changing the time there. So we can take, let the speed be x. I'm not rubbing it so that you can verify this one. Let the speed be x. Let the speed be x and time taken be y. Time taken be y. Then what will be the distance covered? If speed is equal to x and time taken is equal to y, distance covered is speed into time. So distance covered will be equal to xy. Now we can check what is the condition given. If the train would have been 6 km per hour faster. So if we are increasing the speed of the train by 6 km per hour, so that will be equal to x plus 6. It would have taken 4 hours less. So time taken will be equal to y minus 4. So in this case, distance travelled will be equal to speed into time. Speed into time will be equal to the distance covered. And distance covered is xy. So here we will write equal to xy. How much? Whatever you are doing, you are changing the speed or anything, but you have to travel a certain distance only, and that is equal to xy. So again we will simplify it, then we will get xy minus 4x plus 6y minus 4 is equal to xy. So xy and xy will get cancelled, and we can shift all the expression to right hand side to make the coefficient of x positive. Then it will be equal to 4x minus 6y plus 4 is equal to 0. And as you can check, the expressions are divisible by 2. So we can cancel it by 2. 2x minus 3y plus 2 is equal to 0. Make it equation number 1. Now what is the next information given? Next information they are saying, if the train was slower by 6 km per hour. So if we are reducing the speed by 6 km per hour, it would have taken 6 hours more. So in that case, time taken will be equal to 6 hours more. But speed into time is equal to distance covered. And distance covered is xy. So simplify it. Xy plus 6x minus 6y plus minus 36. Xy plus 6x minus 6y minus 36 is equal to xy. So xy and xy will get cancelled. We will get 6x minus 6y is minus 36 is equal to 0. So here you can check, it is divisible by 6. But we are not going to divide it by 6. So either you can divide it by 3 or we can divide it by 2. Why I am saying in this way? Because here coefficient of x is 2. So to make the coefficient equal, either you can divide it by 3. Then it will be equal to 2x, or you can divide it by 2. That depends on you. So suppose if I am dividing it by 3. Dividing by 3. Then what will come? 2x minus 3y minus 12 is equal to 0. Equation 2. Now you can solve equation. I have divided it by 3. So here it will be equal to 3 2s are 6. 2x minus 2y minus 12 is equal to 0. Equation 1 and 2 you can solve. And after solving, the question is find the length of the journey. Means you have to calculate the distance, and distance is equal to xy. So at last you will get the answer 720 km. So just to check whether you will get the same answer or not. In these type of questions, I am covering all the questions from your textbook also. So all of you do all the questions regularly. And one more thing, prepare for the exams also. All the best. Thank you.